want to welcome you here and wish you a Merry Christmas, and I hope you enjoy the time that we have together, the presentation that we have in store for you, entitled Almost There this evening. And this is a wonderful presentation. They put a lot of work into this. But before we begin, let's just open with a quick word of prayer. God, we just thank you that we as your people can come together and that we can just have a moment at the end of our days to just relax and just to ponder the things of your word. Lord, I just pray a blessing on this evening, the music that's sang, and Lord, we just pray that everything that's done is glorifying to your name. In your name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
You're almost there. The waiting is almost over. Do you hear what I hear? Christmas, come. Sing with me one more time. Wanting and the wishes. What joy could be wrapped you beneath that tree? The mystery captured your heart as the sights, the smells, and the sounds of Christmas mingled in your mind and created the wonder of a child. Manger scenes and tinfoil wings, wise men and shepherds, oh holy night, and peace on earth. What I see?
It's that time of year, Christmas bells.
Just like you, every story has a beginning. Christmas didn't begin in that stable in Bethlehem, not when Mary considered these things in her heart. No, the child in Mary's womb was the Word that made the worlds. He was the God who spoke, and the universe was. He was the beginning.
Hear it again,
as if for the first time. Let it mingle with your memories. And before we continue on with the story, taste the triumph of Christmas. Hark, the herald angels sing.
You're almost there.
Joseph, a carpenter, an honest and faithful man who did the right thing at the right time. But it must have been confusing. Then he looked at her.
God has not forsaken.
almost there. Mary can feel the baby move, the Word made flesh, who stepped out of everywhere into a little somewhere, an insignificant somewhere, into a virgin's womb, into a stable in Bethlehem, to save the poor fallen world that He so loved. He is the comfort in your suffering. He is the end of your misery. He is the sleep He gives because He loves you. He is the rest after your hard work, God with us. He is eternity's sonnet, is heaven's hallelujah. He is the shepherd of the glorified. He is the song of the redeemed. He is the chorus of angels. He is the everlasting oratorio, the great orchestra of the sky. We worship you, Emmanuel, all divine. In you, your Father's glory shines.
Thank you.
Emmanuel, God with us, the creator of all things becomes a creature, a child. He is closer than your heartbeat. Prince of Peace, Mighty God, Emmanuel.
Oh,
great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace amongst those with whom he is."